Right, that's Tuesday dealt with. Let's take a look at Wednesday now. Half seven mass. I can take that. And maybe, could you take the 8 o'clock at all? Right, I can take that as well. Now, the half six evening mass on Sunday. Evening mass? Too early. No problem, I can take that as well. I just make a note.
Morning, Ted.
Morning, Dougal. Dougal, there's some shaving cream just there.
No, there's not, Ted. No, you're grand.
No, on you.
Oh, where exactly, Ted?
Just there, below your ear.
Here.
Yes, and there's a bit more.
Gone.
No, there's still just a tight... Dougal, it's all over the place.
Oh, God. How on earth did all that get there? I didn't even shave this morning. So, what are we doing today, Ted? Confessions and mass and things like that, I suppose.
Yes, Dougal, things like that.
It's great being a priest, isn't it, Ted? God, it's lovely out. Oh, wait till I tell you, Ted. Funland's coming to Craggy Island. It'll be here Saturday.
Oh, yes, this is the fairground thing. I wouldn't have much interest in that type of thing myself, to be honest.
They've got a spider baby.
A what?
A spider baby. You know, it's kind of a freak show thing, you know. It's got the body of a spider, but it's actually a baby. And...
How is it a baby? Does it have a nappy on it or something?
No.
Well, does it have the head of a baby?
No.
Well, if it looks like a spider and it doesn't actually gurgle at you or anything, how do you know it's actually a baby?
They keep it in a pram.
Dougal, are you absolutely sure about this? You're not confusing it with a dream you had or anything?
No, honestly, I saw it on the news. Honestly, I... Oh, wait now, actually. Now that you say it, it was a dream, yeah.
Have you been studying this like I told you?
Oh, I have, Ted, I have, yeah. Sorry about that, but we should go anyway, Ted. Come on, it'll be great. Last year I had a go with the horse riding and it was just fantastic.
I didn't know you could ride horses.
Well, it wasn't a real horse, Ted, like... It was this owl fella with a saddle on him. God, he must have been about 80, you know. Well, of course, he couldn't go very fast. Like, you know, I was kind of lashing him with the whip and all that. But couldn't get much of a response out of him, you know.
And how long were you up on him?
Oh, I'd say it was about an hour.
So you were up on an 80-year-old man, riding him around and whipping him for 60 minutes. You realise that image will stay with me for the rest of my life.
I know, Ted, yeah, it's great, isn't it? Come on, we should go.
No, I don't think I could take the excitement, to be honest.
Suppose I'll just see if there's anything on the television, though.
What type of jumper is that, anyway?
Well, basically, it's a four.
Maybe I'll just go and study the old diagram.
Hello, Father. Ted Crilly speaking.
Hello, Father. Sorry to disturb you. My name is Terry McNamee. I'm producing the programme Faith of Our Fathers for Telly Aaron at the moment. We're doing a special on priests who work in isolated communities, and I was wondering if you'd be interested in talking to us.
Well, that's very, That's very exciting. Faith of Our Fathers is my favourite programme, you know.
Well, you were the first person we thought of. If you are interested, I could come over. And we could give you a small fee for your trouble.
Well, that was it.
Who's that, Ted?
No one.
No one?
Hello, Father Crilly.
No.
Must be someone, Ted.
Well, just a moment. son.
Oh, quick question. How exactly do you get to Craggy Island, Father? It doesn't seem to be on any maps.
No, it wouldn't be on any maps now, Terry. We're not exactly New York. No, the best way to find it is generally to head out from Galway and go slightly north till you see the English boats with the nuclear symbol on the side. They go very close to the island when they're dumping the old glow-in-the-dark.
One thing. Are there any other priests living there with you? Our researcher doesn't mention anyone else.
No, there's no one else here.
I'll see you on Saturday, then. I'll give you a call when I get there.
Bye.
The answer back, Ted.
Never turn on the television when Father Jack's asleep. You know how he is.
But he's always asleep.
Yes, well, anyone who's served the church as long as he has deserves a rest. It's actually quite an honour for us to look after him in his old age, you know. Look at him, dreaming of past glories, no doubt.
Girls, pay attention. We've got a special treat today. Father Hackett has very kindly volunteered to take an all for volleyball practice. All right, Father. And he's just reminded me that it's very warm today, so there'll be no need for your tracksuit tops.
Hello. Father Dougal Maguire here, and welcome to this week's Top of the Pops. And in at number 45 this week is Father Ted Crilly with I've Got the Power. And at number 15 for the 16th week in a row is Father Jack Hackett with I'm a Sleepy Priest.
How does that gobshite get on the television?
Is the television broken again, Father?
Yes, we had a bit of trouble with
it. Never you mind. There's nothing wrong with it that can't be fixed with a bit of you-know-what in the head department. Now then, who's for tea?
Me, please, Mrs. Doyle.
Tea? Fick!
I'm fine, Mrs. Doyle.
You won't have a cup.
Ah, no, thanks, Mrs. Doyle. Honestly, I won't have a cup.
Are you sure now it's hot?
No, I'm not in the mood, thanks.
All right, so. I go on, would you not have a drop?
No, thanks anyway,
just
Mrs.
A
Doyle.
Cup.
I'm fine. No, really.
I'll tell you what, Father. I'll pour
seriously.
A cup for you anyway.
Ah!
And you can have it if you want. Now. And what do you say to a cup?
Fake off, cup!
He loves his cup of tea.
Fake off!
There you go.
Fake off!
Father Crilly, I nearly forgot. There was a phone call earlier from a Terry McNamee.
Ah, right.
Who's that, Ted?
I've never heard of him.
Well, he's something to do with the... Wasn't it the television?
Yes, he's coming to fix the television.
Yeah, well, he'll be here tomorrow at 12.
Grand.
Yeah, it's good you called someone, Ted. Still not working.